I'm with Eric Russell. And Eric, I want to ask you a question. Why in the world would a successful defensive coordinator at Georgia leave there to come to a school that hasn't had football since Pearl Harbor and coach a bunch of vagabonds in secondhand uniforms? It sounds crazy. Why'd you do it?
Well, John, I'm sure a lot of people thought I was crazy, and maybe I was, but for new and different challenges and experiences, not that I was in a rut at Georgia, we had just won a national championship, but this place excited me. The president, Dale Lick at that time, wanted a football team, and he wanted it to be Division I, and I thought that would be real interesting.
How do you go from club football one year to a national championship a mere 4 years later?
Well, we had good players. The players who played good together had great support from our administration, student body, faculty, and we had a lot of luck.
We started. We didn't have these practice fields. We didn't have a football. We didn't have anything. And we were just kind of plowing a field that nobody else had ever plowed. So I'm surprised every day.
Third and 10 for Georgia Southern.
What a great time for Georgia Southern, Southern Boosters, all the faculty and all the students at Georgia Southern College.
Enjoy this
stand
one.
Up and be proud.
Five,
four,
seconds.
Four,
three,
two, it's all
one.
Over, folks.
This one's
national
championship. The second national championship in a row.
Every time that I look in the mirror, all these lies. Past is gone, it went by like dust to dawn. Isn't that the way? Everybody's got the do's and not the way.
Hamill straight back, four-man rush. Hamill airs it out deep, looking for Bradford, and he overthrew it. This one is intercepted.
Half my life's in books, written pages, live and learn from fools and from sages. You know it's true. All the things come back to you.
Give Montana a chance to grab a toehold.
Oh, he's up there.